first aesthetic is the Instagram influencer persona. This girl's super stylish, very cool, always on top of the latest fashion trends. She's kind of someone I aspire to be, but at the same time, I don't really want to completely embody her because she's a super active social media presence and her life is essentially online. I went for the basic influencer trends with this look, a pair of Levi's, cool black sunglasses that I feel like all the Instagram girls are constantly rocking, and a cool little chain loop belt to add a touch of style. And then all the Instagram girls have these cute little black shoulder bags, but my black shoulder bag is actually not in this apartment, so instead I just wrapped a crossbody bag around my shoulder a couple times and hope no one would notice. This would not be complete without a pair of Nike Air Force Ones. These shoes are like the most worn shoes of the year, and I'm clearly no exception to that trend. I mean, hey, I love them, they're great shoes. To accessorize, I chose these really cool snake earrings that I thought went well with my personal version of this aesthetic. That's all for this girl, and hey, follow me on Instagram if you want. Now, this side of my personality doesn't come out incredibly often, but when my skater girl aesthetic does emerge, it's pretty fun and I always feel really cool, for lack of a better word. She's not girly at all, almost an alter ego of a good portion of my closet. And this girl might not actually be able to shred on a skateboard, but she certainly looks the part and has the skate mentality, and hey, that's kind of what's most important. I really like loud graphics when I'm going for the skater vibe, usually Harley Davidson or another motorcycle or skate brand. The shirt I'm wearing in this video is for a motocross competition, and I really like how bold it is with the text as well as the colors. And then a beanie is kind of a classic. I really like the Carhartt ones because they are cute and easy to find, and they're also really cozy and good for the Montreal winters. And then my personal skate aesthetic is not complete without some ultra-ripped jeans and some Vans, which I don't think I showed, so my bad, the camera can only capture so much in frame. I actually quite like this aesthetic, but to be honest, I don't wear it nearly as often as the other styles, but I feel very cool girl when I am wearing it, and it's a nice side to explore and a fun trend to style and play around with. Let's be honest, as a white girl, I have to have my Brandy Melville aesthetic. I don't think I'm going out on a limb to say that a good percentage of teenage girls have close to this exact outfit, and it is a little culty, but it's just kind of the way it is. Usually I like to believe that I have my own unique style, but sometimes I leave the house looking like I walk straight out of the Brandy Melville Instagram feed. This girl is pretty basic, for lack of a better word. She's usually rocking head-to-toe Brandy, often some kind of a plaid bottom with a borderline too small top, complete with platform docks and some early 2000s hair accessories that you either pulled out of a drawer in your childhood bedroom or spent way too much money on. Getting these breasts to look cute in my hair was actually a genuine struggle because my hair does not work in the middle part, but hey, it almost works. Couldn't forget the butterfly earrings. The world has been obsessed with butterflies, and Brandy girls are no exception. My Brandy aesthetic is almost a mean girl, but leans a little more sassy, and even though she thinks her outfits are super cute, she looks like a carbon copy of all the other small blonde Brandy girls on the internet. Next we have the art ho aesthetic. As an art history major, I'd say I spend a lot of my time looking at art and probably love it more than the average person. And I think that has definitely influenced my style and pushed me to explore different facets of my fashion taste. This aesthetic is pretty true to my personality and my daily style, very artsy with lots of pretty dresses and accessories like this silk patterned bandana and little safety pin earrings. I have these two pretty art books that my boyfriend got me that I absolutely love, and reading is a big part of the art ho aesthetic. She's always got a book on hand, whether it be art or fiction. This girl is cute and casual, but still has her own unique fashion taste. She loves thrifting and vintage pieces, layering things, and wearing more unique colors and patterns. No outfit is truly complete without platform Doc Martens. These are absolutely my favorite shoes and seem to make their way into every aesthetic I have. This girl's a little more reserved and a bit more quiet and sweet, but she's pretty smart and she studies hard, although only for her art classes. Ah, the high school dropout. Now, this aesthetic was one that I almost exclusively wore for close to 2 years in high school. Although not actually being a high school dropout in the true essence of the term, I did stop going to normal high school my junior year and instead took classes at a community college and focused on ballet and other things. So I was low-key a bit of a high school dropout. I was very edgy at this time, very moody, and I loved wearing all black. This aesthetic doesn't really need a specific outfit since I have a ton of different black clothes that satisfy my edgy fashion needs, but since it's summer, I popped on shorts. Honestly, all I really need to feel edgy is my black leather jacket, black boots, and all black accessories. I even had my hair dyed black for about 2 years, so there's a lot of very edgy history hiding behind these blonde locks. This girl is a bad girl. She's pretty badass, doesn't really take shit from anybody, and she's quite confident and cool. although she's not the happiest person, so I'm glad that I've grown out of this aesthetic for everyday wear. But that being said, there are still days and nights out where I just want to rock all black and I feel the best when I'm wearing it head to toe. If there is one aesthetic that embodies my soul more than anything else, that would be the prairie girl. I was born in the Palouse Prairie in Idaho, and I've never really grown out of the small town way of life. I love this free-spirited, carefree kind of style and energy. For me, my prairie girl aesthetic is heavily reliant on flowy floral dresses with big chunky sweaters over top. My hair is always either in braids, a headband, or loose pigtails like these. My prairie aesthetic also encompasses my plant mother persona, and I truly love my plants like they are my own children. I probably have like 30 in my house and love them all so much. This prairie girl is young and spirited, and she moves with the wind and can't really be tied down. She can be found running through fields, typically barefoot, and 9 times out of 10 you can probably catch her dancing and bouncing around. I love this girl and I love this side of my personality. This aesthetic is definitely one that I thrive in. The East Coast wannabe is an aesthetic that I find myself slipping into quite often in Montreal. She's really nothing like my West Coast style whatsoever, and I only wear this kind of outfit and these types of clothes when I'm living on the East Coast for university. Even so, I really do like this girl, and she definitely has some of my best traits. She's very put together and has her whole life organized and would die without her Google Calendar. She has her summer internship confirmed by February, she does great in school, has a lot of friends, and is a city girl and a go-getter. She loves fashion and shopping, she dresses very classy and put together. This aesthetic consists of any kind of plaid pants with a nice coat over top. I threw on some really nice leather booties as well, kept my hair casual in a low messy bun with some subtle accessories, just these small little silver hoops. Another key element of this aesthetic is the brands. She wears a ton of Zara and Aritzia, two brands that you would never find in Washington. My style really does a complete 180 when I step off the plane into Montreal. Ah, the Upper Res party girl. Upper Res was the freshman dorm that I stayed in my first year of university, and you can find a whole gaggle of these girls there. This girl loves to party, she loves going out, she literally hits Cafe Tuesday, Suwu Wednesday, and is out all weekend. She never seems to get hungover and still manages to make it to her 8:30s, a skill I unfortunately did not carry with me into my later years. She's wearing a pretty basic, very classic going out outfit, some overly ripped jeans and a little wrap top, big hoop earrings, and of course, my drink of choice, straight vodka. This girl's fun, bubbly, loves to dance, loves a good time, is always down to have fun. She's definitely an energetic, dancey drunk, although she can get a little bit floppy. No clubbing outfit would be complete without going out shoes, sneakers that you wouldn't mind getting absolutely destroyed. These are once white Vans, and they now have adopted this lovely beige shade. Unfortunately, with the whole quarantine thing, this girl has not really had a chance to get out and shine. She's been stuck inside, not really having much fun. But one day, she will dance again. The Pacific Northwest aesthetic is one that I wore for years before ever coming to Montreal. This one is very easy to recreate, it's just your choice of Patagonia with Crocs or Chacos and any color hydro flask and you're good to go. Unfortunately, my Crocs are broken and they can't go into adventure mode, but I still managed to make them work. But seriously, I love this girl. She's super outdoorsy, loves to go hiking, backpacking, camping, paddleboarding, you name it. She's a Washington girl through and through and loves her state, loves the Pacific Northwest, very passionate about nature. She's a go-with-the-flow kind of girl, and she thrives in the summertime when she can spend all of her time outside. Some key accessories for my PNW aesthetic are stacks of friendship bracelets made by me and my friends, and I love the look of tons of rings, especially for the summer. When this girl gets more dressed up, she's very boho, but this is just her day-to-day look, perfect for any outdoor activity and ending the day watching the sunset with a bonfire by the beach.